Jason.
Piss off! None of your kind will get...
Thank you.
manage to find the place?
Not that hard. It's not exactly a small concealed hovel.
I must say, of all the creatures in this region, I find steeds most intriguing. Horses interest you at all, Witcher?
All the same to me. Call each one I ride Roach.
Strange. The grey is Cantarella, sired by Cahir, the champion from Vol.
Yeah. Grey's a good color. Even looks good on horses.
My coin's on the black stallion, Nemrod, purest Nilfgaardian stock.
Surprised he didn't salute you, General. Seem to know your horses.
I find them to be far more honest than men. Must say, I'm curious how you manage in the saddle, Witcher.
Mostly just try to stay in it.
What would you say to a little race?
Not what I came here for.
Don't make me beg, Witcher. Tell you what, win, and I shall give you my finest saddle, made in Nilfgaard proper of beautifully tanned leather.
Why not? Wouldn't mind seeing if your knowledge of horses translates into riding skills.
Ha! Splendid! In that case, you must choose a mount.
I'll ride Nemrod. Pit a Nilfgaardian stallion against a Nilfgaardian general.
In that case, I shall try my luck on the Zeracanian Bay. The horses are saddled. Let's begin.
Riders, ready!
I adore the speed, the rush of air!
Sick of it.
Hey-ya!
Come on, Witcher! Let's see what you're made of! I adore the speed, the rush of air! Let's see what you're made of.
The Roach I chose put in a nice run.
Exceptional. I've not lost a race in a while. I congratulate you. That is yours. Ah, look. Lady Latar has just arrived.
Who?
The woman formerly known as Molly. There she stands.
Right. Thanks.
I should be here for a time. Find me if you'd like to ride back to the city together.
Who do you favor, m'lady?
Can't decide between the black stallion and the grey mare. Keep going back and forth, back and forth. Sorry. Don't believe we've been introduced.
I'm Geralt.
Geralt? That Geralt? The one Dandelion's rescued time and time again?
Mm-hmm. Wouldn't be here if not for Dandelion.
Told me all about your adventures. How he'd ready you for battle with his songs. How he tamed the Cairn by playing his lute.
I meant that literally. Dandelion's why I'm here. Came to ask you about him. Know where he might be?
No. Sadly, I haven't got a clue. We've not seen each other in ages. Ever since I became Lady Latard, it's been nothing but balls, banquets, and other such... what's it? Congregations. Awful tiring, all this. But... or maybe his sister could help you. Such a nice girl.
chance you remember your last conversation with Dandelion?
Of course. He came to borrow some coin for a barge.
What? Why do you need a barge?
To take me on a romantic cruise of the canals by the light of the moon. Said there'd be strawberries and that wine with the bubbles, and he'd sing me arias. But I've not seen him since.
You do realize Dandelion doesn't have a sister.
Sure he does. Saw him himself. Funny, she don't look like him at all. Blonde, for starters. Maybe they've different fathers.
Mm-hmm. Different mothers, too.
Maybe. But you could see he cares for her. Looks after her. The way he carried her packages and...
These packages. Any chance they were trunks, travel cases? And this girl. Possibly a Trouberitz?
Yes, yes. Now I remember, she's a traveling performer. Sailed in from Kavir. Talented family, innit?
Exceptionally. And very loving as well, I'm sure.
If you only knew. Dandelion even wrote a poem for her. To my dearest Calinetta. Or some such. Oh, to have a brother like that.
Thanks, Molly.
Wait. Before you go, I've got a request. Dandelion told me once he'd show me his etchings, but he never did. I'd so like to see him.
Won't be too hard to convince him. He loves showing off those etchings to anyone he can.
Oh, that's wonderful! Thanks, and good luck to you on your search. Yeah?
Washed your hair lately?
Nothing hurts as much as life. trouble at the
Come end. On now.
You're back. You met Poppy? She ought to start talking any day now.
That Field Marshal Duda's replacement? The Marshal was a parrot, you do remember, right? Where'd you get her?
At auction. Some mage's estate went under the hammer. Witch hunters and the Eternal Fire joined forces. Staked out his place and rounded the sorry sap up, put his things up for sale. Happened to be passing by and saw this owl. Came with her own cage.
How could you resist?
Couldn't they? It weren't possible. Ah, but dandelions, what matters now. So, how'd you do? Learn much?
Women on my list hadn't seen dandelion in a while. All claimed he had been acting strange. Also mentioned he'd been seeing someone else. Thing is, Mystery Woman wasn't on my list.
What's she supposedly like, this lass?
Blonde, from Kovir. A Trogarids, apparently, named Kalanetta or something like that.
That makes it clear as crystal. It's Priscilla. Aye. Must be her.
Who's this Priscilla?
A Trogarids, like you said. Quite popular of late. Picture dandelion with a pair of tits, and you've got the general idea.
Interesting image. So how'd Dandelion handle meeting his female double?
I think he fell in love.
What can I say? Could be he finally met his match.
She's his match, all right. Maybe more. A laddie's head's on fire. Lassie's got him whirling.
All right. Guess we gotta talk to her.
Priscilla works for the Mummer's troop. Reynard and the Foxen. Whenever they're in town, she performs nightly at the Kingfisher.
Mean we've been sentenced to an evening of poetry?
Must you always? This'll be true poetry, Geralt. You'll see.
The best stock in all Novigrad. No need to push.
No one to push.
Very good. Manners before trade, always.
Let me have a look.
mended his wounds. Geralt of Rivia.
One stray in, and before you know it, the neighborhood's full of them.
Cost me.
Go back to Farcor.
Do you want to get slapped? A Witcher. You're into it now.
The more I drink.
Dandelion's poetry. The kingfisher preened, then fell in the latrine. Know it?
Yeah. Also know the one about Princess Annie, who drowned in the River Fanny.
Yes. At any rate, the kingfisher welcomed poetry lovers with open arms. Some of the brightest stars in the literary firmament performed here.
What are you serving today?
here already. Come on, let's find some arse rests. Should start soon.
Have yearned for your tender caress to bind our fortunes. Damn what the stars own. Rend my heart open, then your love profess. A winding, weaving fate to which we both atone. You flee, my dream comes. Your scent, berries tart, lilac sweet. To dream of raven locks and twisted stormy, of violet eyes glistening as you weep. The wolf I will follow into the storm to find your heart. Its passion displaced by our ever growing, hardening into stone. Amidst the cold, to hold you in a heated embrace, you flee. My dream come the morning. Your scent, berries tart, lilac sweet. To dream of raven locks and twisted stormy, of violet eyes glistening as you weep. I know not if fate would have us live as one, or if by love's blind chance we've been bound. The wish I whispered. When it all began, did it forge a love you might never have found? You flee, my dream, come the morning. Your scent, berries tart, lilac sweet. To dream of raven locks and twisted stormy.
Temerian boys back at White Orchard.
Silence, woman. We've come to hear music.
A murderer?
There's a war on. Some die.
Oh, please, argue this out elsewhere.
Squabbles and rows again. And I was told this was a decent establishment.
If I know Geralt, he risked his noggin to save someone else's arse.
Save, you say? He murdered folk.
Don't let him provoke you.
There's the door. Settle this outside.
Come. I wish to listen to music. Music!
Cultural capital of the world? The fuck it is.
Permit me to introduce this here's Priscilla, known also as Calinetta, as lovely as she is talented. And this
is Geralt of Rivia, I know. Dandelion's told me a great deal about you, and I've listened with bated breath. Don't be surprised. After all, doubt I could think of a more fitting subject for a ballad than a witch's love for a sorceress. Or should I say, sorceresses.
Seems Dandelion was meticulous in telling my story, down to personal and insignificant details. Did he offer anything about himself, like where he was going?
Splendid! Very funny, truly. So, see you later. Not here. Come with me.
There a reason for all this sneaking around?
An excellent one. When last I saw Dandelion, he told me he was planning a heist. Siggy Reuben's vault?
Sheeped up.
And I've not seen him since.
Let me guess. Attempted heist was a failure.
Well, he's not driven up in a gilded carriage laden with jewels, so I should think so. I've asked after him everywhere. But it seems an army of tongue-stealing cats has overrun the city. I learned only that he raised a ruckus at Horson Jr.'s lair. Then Horson's men chased him all over town.
Horson Jr. doesn't ring a bell.
Biggest prick in Novigrad. Not literally, but...
Got it. You're not a fan. But what did he do to you?
Try the whole town. He's one of four bosses who control the city's underworld. The others being Siggy Reuben, Carlo the Cleaver Varess, and the King of Beggars.
That rascal. At least he didn't cross the church as well. Bring that venerable institution into it. We'd be in deep then.
Here I go again, rushing to Dandelion's rescue. He ought to pay me a salary.
Whoever he is, I sincerely doubt he's in the mood for jokes. Nor am I, in fact.
Relax, I'll get him out of this. Gotta talk to this Horson first. And Siggy Reuben. Know where I might find them?
I don't know about Horson, but Reuben runs a bathhouse. Careful, though. He's a dangerous character.
So am I.
I don't doubt it. But Dandelion's not. I beg you to hurry it. Let me know as soon as you learn anything.
Well, the bugger all two here. Heading back to the Rosemary. Got Poppy to feed. And then I suppose I'll wait. See if our warbler don't come home on his own.
Take care now. Lump. Nothing works up a first-rate business.
Oh, God. A reaper's come for me.